This match will consist of one tiebreak set using no added scoring.
Only one standing in the whole place.
So then I went and saw her. She was with, they do the variety where they have one person with the other, one of the other people that were in the, that were on the main stage. And she was doing an act with the comedian guy. At some point she said something goofy. That way I yelled, "Yippee!" And she started laughing because she knew that's what the joke was from a prior show. I was yelling, "Yippee."
So it's easier to finish, but
seemed very relaxed and very easygoing. It was great to see.
One thing about the energy of this crowd here in Seattle for this event.
Great energy, you guys are unbelievable. When we feel the love of the crowd and you guys actually really enjoying yourselves tonight, and that for me is most important. We're going to try our best to make a good match, but if you guys are into it, that helps a lot.
And Roger, of course, Bill actually said that you were a gentleman and you let him get all the balls. And then you had John Isner say you didn't help Bill at all. What do you have to say to both of those guys?
I'll try my best. I can't do more than that.
Wait, but I can't.
seconds. Last year was extremely difficult, having had surgery and the knee never really healing, then I had back pain too, and I don't got too much at Wimbledon, and pulled the plug and was out for 6 months, but was able to spend some incredible time with the family, start preparing for this season, and hoping that all the work that I put on for the off-season was going to really pay off, and I was going to get a second chance to play tennis again on the professional tour. And so when I did come back in Australia, it was really exciting for me. So happy, just lost first round, but the body being fine, because I want to be able to walk away from tennis as a healthy man, so it's good to take time off and shows off that day the time is a good thing, so I'm really, really pleased.
Father, you have a photographic memory, you can tell me the score of a match 15 years ago, but I got a question. When did you realize what a difference you could make into the lives of kids all over the world, especially the kids in Africa? When did you realize what a difference you could make?
Well, I mean, the press are funny people sometimes. When you first match and they ask you, what are you going to do with all the prize money you won? And you're like, well, put it in the bank, or I pay back my parents, or you know, something like that. But then eventually, you know, you start winning more and you become more famous and you realize the impact you have on kids. And when you're doing kids' clinics in a little way, you know, they look at you. Like I was in Walmart for a couple of years in my hometown tournament. That was the best thing in the world, to chase players for autographs, even though we were not allowed to, but I didn't care. I chased them. I was the obnoxious guy, so if the ball boys want to do it here, the girls, that's totally fine, you know. I'm always up for it, but no, but all of a sudden, you know, you get in this position where you feel like, well, you're really lucky to be playing on the pro tour, and maybe you could actually do more and give back. And I thankfully had some great people in sports, or and others who have done so well in philanthropy, and I just thought, you know, I'll start super young. It was about over almost 15 years ago now when I started the foundation, and I look back and it's been incredibly successful. I've had just two matches for Africa in this month, 3 and 4, and we were able to raise over $4 million with the two events. So it's spending a lot of time there when I was a kid, you know, I saw there was poverty and there was need to help, and that's when I started to support children in South Africa, first in South Africa, then in Southern Africa, and what we do now for early childhood education, and we've helped over 600,000 kids now, and the goal is by the end of 2018 that a million kids have benefited from the foundation. So it's amazing I can do this, and I know
$2 million.